Some of you may be watching and listening, and you're thinking, why are we saying these things out loud? Man, there's power in words, and we're declaring these things over our lives. We're reminding ourselves of these truths, that we're not going to quit. We're in it to win it, that God's plans for us are always good, that, man, we belong to God. And so we're going to keep this thing going. We are getting ourselves in position for motion, for movement, because God has things for us to do on the earth. Hey, everybody, welcome to the Live, Love, Lead podcast, a podcast designed to help you live, love, and lead well. I'm your host, April Nicole Scipio. So excited that you are joining me on today's podcast episode. We are on a new series, and it's all about mindset. Today is part one, and we're going to be talking about mindset for motion. Now, in 2 weeks, part two will air, and then 2 weeks after that, part three will air. And so you want to make sure that you are subscribed to the podcast so that you don't miss an episode. Huge shout out to the Live Lovely community. Last month, we hit the 10,000 download mark, and that is just such a huge milestone for us as a community. Thank you for being a part of this and listening and sharing and subscribing. You guys are truly amazing. Before we jump into today's episode, I want to let you know about my new 6-week online course that will be launching. Registration opens March 18th, and it's called Reset. It's really designed to help you get a healthy mindset, but then build this foundation for growth. I'm super excited about this. Space is limited, so make sure to get on the wait list so that you don't miss registration. You can find out more information on my website, and that is aprilnicolescipio.com. Now, we're jumping into mindset for motion today. Motion is all about movement, and that's what God is about. He's about moving. He's about taking steps. He's about getting us to the destination, right? He has a journey that we're all on. He has assignments for all of us. And in order for us to get there, we have to keep taking steps. So we're going to look at a few scriptures today that really encourage us to stay in motion, right? When you are going after the things that God has for you, you know, there's opposition. And that's not to scare us or intimidate us. That's just so we can be aware, so that we can be aware of our thoughts and be aware that we're constantly taking steps. We're not letting obstacles or challenges hold us back or stop us from fulfilling the destiny that God has for us. And so let's first look at Philippians chapter 3. This is verses 12 and 14 in the ESV. It says, "Not that I have already obtained this or am already perfect, but I press on to make it my own, because Christ Jesus has made me his own. Brothers, I do not consider that I have made it my own, but one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead, I press on toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus." This verse is so encouraging because Paul's writing here. He's like, hey, I'm straining forward. I love that language because sometimes when we are moving forward and we're taking steps, it is a challenge at times. It is a strain, but we have to keep pressing. Why? He tells us in this verse, it says, because Christ Jesus has made me his own. You see, we press on because Christ Jesus has made us his own. We belong to him. And if we belong to him, that gives us the courage and the strength to keep going, because we recognize that what we're doing is beyond us. It's all about him. It's all about bringing his glory. And we want our lives bringing him glory. Today, we're going to do some declarations. And because we want to build a healthy mindset around motion, around taking steps, around moving forward, I want you to say this after me. I want you to say, I belong to God. Go ahead, right where you are, whether you're watching or listening. Let's do that again. Say, I belong to God. That's right. You belong to God. And so that's the mindset that we want to be in as we're moving forward. The next scripture I want to read is Jeremiah 29:11. This is the ESV. "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope. You see, we must solidify in our minds that God's plan for us is good. It says in this verse, it says, plans for welfare and not for evil. You see, God's plans for us never change. They are for our welfare. They are for good. They are for our success. In fact, as much as you want to be successful, God wants you to be successful so much more. And I want to encourage you today that sometimes we get off the path and we start going the wrong way, or sometimes we take a detour, but that doesn't mean the destination changes. God's plan for you is always good. And sometimes it's just going to Him saying, man, Lord, I missed it. Show me how to get back on the path. Show me the best right step for me to take. And He's so faithful to show us. So we have to be in this mindset as we move forward that, man, God desires for me to be successful. Let's declare this today together. I want you to repeat after me. God's plan for me is always good. Let's try that again. God's plan for me is always good. I want to look at one last verse. It's Hebrews chapter 12. I'm going to read verses 1 and 2 in the ESV. It says, therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and sin which clings so closely. And let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, looking to Jesus, the founder and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is seated at the right hand of the throne of God. You see, moving forward is not a sprint, guys. It's a marathon. And marathons, they take endurance. I love how this verse says, keep our eyes on Jesus because he endured. Guys, it says he endured the cross. We can't even fathom what that was like, but we know that was not, that wasn't easy. That was weighty, right? He had the weight of the sin on him. But he endured because he had us in mind. He endured because it was joy that was set before him. And now this verse says he's seated at the right hand of the throne of God. You see, Jesus endured and he experienced everything that God had for him. And that's just like us as we look to him for our example. God has amazing things for our lives, but it requires us to endure. It requires us to press on. It requires us to overcome. And as we overcome, as we don't quit, as we don't give up, man, we will experience all that God has for us. And as we're building a healthy mindset today, I want you to repeat after me. I am in it to win it. Let's say that again. I am in it to win it. Some of you may be watching and listening and you're thinking, why are we saying these things out loud? Man, there's power in words, and we're declaring over this. We're declaring these things over our lives. We're reminding ourselves of these truths that we're not going to quit. We're in it to win it. That God's plans for us are always good. That, man, we belong to God. And so we're going to keep this thing going. We are getting ourselves in position for motion, for movement, because God has things for us to do on the earth. I want to pray for us today. And I want us to just pray out these things that we are keeping our thoughts healthy. As we take steps for motion, we're knowing, that we belong to God, that God has good things for us, and that we're not going to quit. And we're just going to pray that over ourselves today. God, thank you so much for the ability to renew our minds. And God, first, I just want to pray blessings over this entire series, God. I know that people's lives will be changed because you are working on the inside of us. Thank you that you desire us to have a healthy mindset. And today, God, we just declare that, man, we belong to you and we are so thankful. Thank you that you are our good shepherd and you take such good care of us. God, thank you that your plans for us are plans of success, plans of good. And those plans don't change, that you don't ever change your mind about us, that your plans for us are always good. And God, we thank you that we're not going to quit. We're in it to win it, God. We are drawing strength from you. We're drawing courage from you, God. And we thank you that we are moving forward. God, thank you for this mindset for motion. God, we love you, we honor you, and we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen, guys. If you have enjoyed this episode, man, please share it on socials and tag me at April Nicole Sip. I'd love to hear all about how you're building a healthy mindset for motion. Don't forget to rate, review, and subscribe to the podcast so you don't miss an episode. Ladies, if you are looking for a community where you want to build some authentic friendships centered around God's word, make sure to join me over on Facebook in the Live Lovely community. We'd love to have you. I'm looking forward to next time. I'll see you guys soon. Until then, go live, love, and lead well. Have an amazing day.